Sunday night.
A good neighbor to nearby downtown Phoenix. We're at State Farm Stadium here in Glendale, Arizona. And everybody, thanks so much for joining us. You picked a fun one to tune into. I'm Kate Scott, joined by former NFL quarterback Brock Heuerdin. We've got two quarterbacks here, Brock, who are known for playing a very exciting brand of football. Not just throwing the rock, but taking it themselves, too.
Yep, these are two of the guys who really epitomize the direction that this position's going in the modern NFL.
Yep.
Pocket passers, they'll have their place, they always will. A lot of teams look to somebody like this as the default. A great passer, but someone who can also mix in plenty of rushing yards and keep that defense honest.
Prater ready to get this one going. And away we go in Glendale. Here's a return from the 7. And he's brought down. The offense will come onto the field. So now out comes the Panther offense for its initial drive of the game. They'll be led out by the first player picked in the 2023 NFL Draft from Alabama. It's Bryce Young.
Watching Bryce Young at Alabama, he just made the game look so easy. One of those rare prospects where everything just feels like it's in slow motion and he's in total control. Well, fast forward to the NFL, and he took a beating early in his career. Everything must have felt like a blur. But there's no denying the promise he has as a quarterback, that high upside that made him the number one pick overall.
And this one does not go far. Two on the pickup there, and it's going to be 2nd and 8.
I think one thing you learn, Kate, when you transition from college to the NFL, not every run is going to be a big play. Some of them, well, they're just destined to end in a minimal gain, and some of them will set up that critical play action for later.
Second and 8. That's complete to Leggett. And he's going to be brought down at the 42.
Well, that's a modest little drag route, but if you ever just need a safe short gain on the throw, that's a go-to route to target.
All plays on the table here for 3rd and 3. Shotgun snap, looking to throw. And that's a win for the pass rush. Hit as he threw it, leads to the incompletion. 4th down coming up.
Well, that's one you chalk up to the pressure earning that incompletion. They came in before he could find a target, hit him, altered that last second attempt to get rid of him.
So on 4th down now, the Panthers calling an all-pro several times over. It's Johnny Hecker for the punt. That hits at the 9, but nobody around to grab it. It carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. So here come the Cardinals now as they get sent for their opening drive. And they'll be led out by a number one pick out of Oklahoma. One of the game's better runners, it's Kyler Murray.
A reconstructed knee limited Kyler Murray to just 8 games a season ago. But in those 8 games, Kate, we got a chance to see those feet once again come to life. Man, is he dynamic when he's 100%. And when he can complement that running ability with some accuracy and anticipation in the passing game, this guy is a nightmare for defensive coordinators to contain.
Murray to throw. He finds the rookie from Ohio State. And he'll go down after pushing this up to the 29.
That is a textbook first down completion. Sets up 2nd and very manageable. Create space to take that shot downfield.
Nice spot here for the offense. It's 2nd and 1. Out of the gun, they'll give it to him inside. And this one's brought to a halt at about the 36-yard line. A 70-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
Most of the people watching will forget about that play in a couple minutes, but the coaches won't forget. He has that filed away the next time he really needs to pick up a few yards.
1st down, ball at the 36. It's Connor again. And they sent it straight ahead, but the front stops him after a gain of 3.
He's brought down at the 39-yard line. It's a pickup of 3. Brings
Second down now, 7 to go. Right back to Connor. And once again, he doesn't manage much before getting brought down. They got 2 yards there. That leaves him with 3rd down and 5. Kyler throwing here. Has the connection to Jones. And they're going to bring him down just on the other side of midfield. They come through with a nice gain there. Gain of 10, first down.
That's what we call situational football. You spend all week working on your nickel passing game package to take advantage of third downs just like that.
A good opening series has him across midfield now with a new set of downs. They'll run here on first down. And that carry only nets one on the plunge up the gut.
Okay, this one you got to be careful to just run it always on first down. You got to break your tendencies. Casual fan, well, that casual fan knew what was coming, but more importantly, this defensive front did too.
They'll come to the line here, 2nd and 9. Here's Kyler to throw. Able to find Jones. And they're going to bring him down at the 36. And that one goes for a gain of 11. And it'll be first down, Arizona.
Well, that is pretty darn impeccable timing between the two. They hit a curl route of that length. It takes great anticipation and precision by the quarterback, and the receiver on the other end finishing it, doing his job.
On first down, they'll run. And that's good yardage there with a new set of downs to boot.
Hey, these are the type of gains he's counted on to get when they're available. Unfortunately, he had tremendous vision to see the seam and get through it before that window could close.
Moving the ball very well out of the gate here. It's set up now at the 26. Now Kyler. Jones reels it in. And he gets this forward to the 19.
That is the epitome of staying on schedule. That kind of completion right there on first down. It opens up the entirety of the playbook for second down. With 3rd and short in your back pocket, you can get even more aggressive and take that shot.
After a good pickup, they're set up with 2nd and short. Straight ahead, it's Connor. And he's dropped just short of the marker, maybe a yard away. Coming up. They're going to try to pick it up with an option left. And he will carry this across for the Arizona touchdown. The Cardinals have a great first drive and get the game's first points. It's a Kyler Murray touchdown. So our first score of the game here as they cap off that drive with a touchdown.
It's really what you're looking for, Kate, offensively. You want to force the other guys into thinking they need to play a little catch-up right away. So a nice job to get that first score and take early control of this game.
Matt Prater for the point after try. That one splits the uprights. And they add one on to their first touchdown of the contest. Now Prater on to send it away. His return starts at the 5. And he's brought down. The offense will come onto the field. Now for the 2nd time, we take a look at this Panther offense. And they haven't gotten very far into their opening script yet, have they? Just a 3 and out to begin this game. offense ready to begin this drive. First and 10. Out of the shotgun, they'll give it to him inside. Give him 24 on that play. And it'll give the Panthers a first down.
I love these inside runs. Don't get away from them. You never know. You think it's going to be a short little gain, and then, boom, get the right blocking, a possessed running back, and you get some serious yards on the table.
One play in, and this drive is already into enemy territory. Play action on first down. This is reeled in by Leggett. And they get there to take him down right around the 41. Second and 3 now. Up the middle, Hubbard. And he's dropped just short of the marker, maybe a yard away.
An offensive group really hoped he was going to get it all right there, reset it back to first down. But instead, defense, they're not going to let anything come easy. And their fight is giving them a chance to stall things out on third and short.
Battle coming up on third and inches. Now it's Young. Complete beyond the marker. And he'll be brought down at about the 29. They come through with a nice gain of 10 and a first down.
You're not going to last long in the National Football League if you don't convert a good chunk of your third downs. Nice find there to continue the series.
Up to the line, and they're set. First and 10. Receiver in motion, headed right. Young looking to throw. Can't handle the hot throw there as it winds up incomplete. No luck finding his receiver that time. And it sets up second down.
Yeah, I know nobody's perfect. All you have to do is listen to me and how many words I screw up. But you certainly expect those throws of that length to be 100%. They've got to be borderline automatic in this offense.
He's got it, room to run. And he'll be brought down here at the 23-yard line.
When you see play action, do all you can to get your eyes to the tight end, because that's their bread and butter. That play action gives him time off the line, helps chip a rusher, or even helps sell that fake. And when he releases, he gets out, he gets some leverage. He gets to that edge before the defender can cover him.
Shotgun now on third down. Thielen's got it, complete. And he's out of bounds, a little short of the 10. It's a pickup of 11. And that'll be good for a Carolina first.
Kid, I can't tell you how good that is. Anticipating the outcut, having the ball on the way before the receiver's head even turns, he puts it on him so that receiver can easily get out of bounds for the nice game.
Hubbard trying this up the gut. And they'll bring him down to put an end to this opening quarter. We will not get another play in here. That's going to do it for quarter number one. 7-0 is our score. We'll return to State Farm Stadium in just a moment. Time for our second quarter here, and the Panthers are thinking points. Hand off on second and short. And they get him right at the line of scrimmage.
That's certainly a spot where you could be more aggressive, Kate, if you wanted to take your shots. But some coaches, even the bolder ones, will take the safe play first when they get it from time to time. No third down required now.
Four downs now to get in. Here's first and goal. They'll try and punch it in. And he runs into a wall there. Multiple defenders ready to stop him cold at the line. No gain for them, and now it'll be second and goal.
You know, Kate, these are the situations in training camp that I love more than anything to watch. You learn so much about a football team in these goal-to-go situations. You know you got to protect that goal line, and the defense, well, it did the job on first down. More to come.
Forced out to, and he's going to score. Touchdown, Carolina! The Panthers can tie it up in the second after cutting into the lead. It's a Bryce Young touchdown. Great play by the QB there, Brock. The play broke down. He didn't have much of a choice other than to escape and improvise. And in the end, turned out to be the best call he could have made.
It is such a necessary tool in today's NFL for that QB to put right in his tool belt, Kate. You know, in my day, you could be a blacksmith, right? You just do the job and stay in the pocket. Not anymore. You got to be an artist. And you got to be an artist that can create when things break down. And that's big time to get a touchdown out of it as well.
That one right down the middle. And we're all tied up. Now Pinheiro on to handle the kickoff. His return starts at the 5. And in the end, Brock, an exciting touchback as the return comes out to the 30. Well, we've already seen some nice plays here, and we're going to see plenty more before this game ends. But you might be thinking, with plays like that, my guy's ratings should be better. Well, you're not alone. You got a chance to let the Madden Ratings Hotline know just what you're thinking. Give them a call, 1-844-MADDEN-1, and make your case for who should get a boost. First and 10 now from the 30. Connor on the inside give. And the plunge up the gut yields nothing there. No progress on first down, and that'll bring up second and 10.
These linebackers of today, they are so quick. They're so twitchy. You don't get a body on them in a hurry, they're going to stick you right at the line of scrimmage.
Second and 10. Need to get some positive yardage here. Back to throw. Murray. Hits his man on the out route. They get an even 10 on that play. And that's a Cardinals first down.
I'm sure coach, play caller doesn't mind making the job a little bit easier. You know, play calling's a lot simpler and easier when you count on the offense to move the chains on those early downs.
New slate of downs to approach here from the 40. Handoff goes to Connor, running left. And he won't win the race to the outside. That run's bottled up at the line. No gain there that time, and it's second and 10.
Made it all look so simple, didn't he? That linebacker sorting right through the traffic, finding the runner. That's instincts come to life.
Second and 10, need to get some positive yardage here. Shotgun snap, looking to throw. He's gonna loft one deep to the left. And he's gonna score. It's an Arizona touchdown. The Cardinals take a second quarter lead. So, Brock, this offense starting to find its rhythm a bit as they finish things with a touchdown there to give them the lead.
And the key word there that you said is finish, because you want to have that mindset, even early in the game, that field goals aren't going to cut it. So that's great work to make sure they finish with 6 points.
Prater on for the PAT. Splits the uprights, and they'll continue adding to their lead. Now Prater on to send it away. Return coming from the 6. And he's brought down. The offense will come onto the field. The Carolina offense headed out now. It's a touchdown ball game right now, Brock. 14-7 as they start this possession. Drive starts out with a first and 10. Putting one of the tight ends in motion right. Quick throw, right side, complete to start this drive. And he's going to get this up to the 45 before he's brought down. That's 16 on the pickup. And it'll give the Panthers a first down.
You want to start a good debate sometime, Kate? Go in an NFL locker room and ask which position is the best athlete. The big guys, the left tackles, will tell you it's them. The corners will tell you it's them. But I'll tell you what, these tight ends of today, the way they can run and break tackles and get in the open field, they truly are some of the best athletes on the team.
Throwing from the gun. Short pass caught by his tight end. And he drives this across midfield and down into enemy territory.
That's what you call efficiency. Exactly what you're looking for in first down. Textbook. It sets up second and very manageable, and it creates that space if you want to take a shot downfield.
After a good pickup, they're set up with second and short. From the 47. Short pass caught by his tight end. And he'll have it down to the 44-yard line. Give him three on that game. And that'll be good for a Carolina first.
That's just great instincts. Go air it out on second down rather than just play conservative and run it. They hit a weak point in the coverage and don't need to worry about third down at all.
They go play action on first. Working across the field, complete. And he works this to the 38 before going down.
Part of the reason I leave you pregame, Kate, and get down to that field and watch these guys throw and catch is I want to see their timing. I want to see their anticipation. That is picture perfect right there. A crossing route thrown that quickly tells me these two are on the same page.
From the 38. It is caught left side. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains.
Sure seems like he knew exactly what he wanted, and he got it, going right where he wanted to with the ball off the snap.
Ball at the 33 for first down. They send a tight end in motion. Here's Young to throw. Tremble with the grab. And that tackle stops him after a solid game.
Every once in a while, it's fine to be conservative on first down, especially when you get enough to stay on schedule and get a little something coming out of it, too.
Second and six coming up here. From the 29, he completes it in traffic. And they bring him down after the play reaches the 26.
You know, I'm really not sure if that was an intentionally brave play to challenge double coverage or just simply not seeing the two defenders. Either way, what a tremendous throw and catch that earns some momentum.
All plays on the table here for third and three. Looking to throw, Young. He has the first over the middle. And he has it down officially to the red zone at the 20. That one ends up a gain of six. And it'll give the Panthers a first down. That brings us to the two-minute warning at Glendale. The Panthers facing a deficit near the break. To the line we go. They're set, first and 10. He'll throw it yet again. Connects with Johnson. And this play reaches the 12-yard line before the stop is made.
Johnson.
a good pickup. They're set up with second and short. Feeling the receiver in motion left. Second and manageable. He's throwing. This throw is caught. And he'll go down shy of the end zone. They mark him at the four. They find 7 yards, and now they've got first and goal.
That pitch and catch won't show up as a big play on the stat sheet, but it gives his own defense a little time to rest. It gives an offensive coordinator a new set of downs to work with.
They'll break the huddle and come up on first and goal. They'll put one of the tight ends in motion. Back to throw. Here's Young. Has it in close. And this one's stopped at the 3-yard line. Now we're going to get an offensive timeout. That's their first. They'll have two left to work with before halftime. It's second and goal. Young to throw it. He's on the move. And he's going to score. Touchdown, Carolina. The Panthers earn the chance to tie it before halftime. It's a Bryce Young touchdown. Wow, great work there by the quarterback. The play broke down. Didn't really have much of a choice other than to escape and improvise. And in the end, Brock, the best call he could have made.
Yeah, and you can do it in different ways in today's NFL, right? The Tom Brady's just recently retired. He did it with his brain. He did it with his mind. But you've got to be able to improvise, as you said. You got to be able to create when a play breaks down. And when you can put six on the board, man, does that infuse your offensive group with confidence.
That one right down the middle. And we're all knotted up. Now Pinheiro on to handle the kickoff. Return coming from the six. And he's brought down. The offense will come onto the field. And they've had a real connection looking his way in our opening half. Seems pretty clear that he's the one the coverage is going to have to adjust to and start slowing down. The drive will start out with a first and 10. Throwing here, Murray. He's gonna lob one deep down the left sideline. And his perfect start is over. And that's the first one of his throws to wind up incomplete. Gonna have to wait a little longer for his first catch of the game. So second down coming up. Now Kyler. He'll get this one to Connor. And he reaches the 35 before going out.
Rhythm. You hear me talk about rhythm a lot. Whether it's a golf swing, a baseball swing, heck, even a bowler gets himself into rhythm. And I'm just telling you, Kate, from experience, these little throws to running backs, it's one of the best things to get your offense into rhythm and a nice little gain on top of it.
Throwing now, third and two. Tight end reels in the shallow throw. And he's going to be brought down at the 42. The Cardinals deciding to use the first of their three timeouts. They'll have two left to work with before halftime. They'll head up first and 10 from the 42. Throwing it again here. That's complete. Here's Connor. And he has it up towards midfield before he's taken down at the 47. A Arizona goes ahead and calls its second timeout. And they still have one in their pocket for what's left of this half. Halfway to the marker, it's second and five. They are throwing it again. Got a man open, complete. And he's able to take this one down to the 25. The Cardinals are going to use the last of their timeouts. And that's all they've got for what little remains of this half. Not much time left in the half, so the kicking team out on first down. This is a 42-yard look from the left hash. And that one is good. A little longer, but no problem at all. And they've taken back the lead.
It depends on the kicker, man. That is a coach's best friend. Saves him so much stress to have a guy he can really trust to go out and get it from that distance consistently. Because from that far out, no kick is a guarantee.
Time left for maybe a return plus a play here as they send this away. And he opts not to bring this one out, so they're going to enjoy some good starting field position from the 30. Probably looking at our final snap of the half here on first down. He'll throw it. And he makes the catch. Oh, but they're going to say he was out of bounds, incomplete. So it's halftime here in Glendale with the Cardinals out in front. Now we'll send things over to Orlando, Florida. Jonathan Coachman on standby, ready to deliver the EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Kate, thanks very much. And welcome in everyone to our EA Sports Halftime Report. In the first half, the Cardinals did what they always do, and that's rely on their quarterback, Kyler Murray. He had a touchdown both in the air and on the ground to help push his guys into the lead at the break.
As always, a hat tip to Coach for his hard work during the break. Kids, we're happy to welcome y'all back for the start of our third quarter. Set up and it's away. Just a three-point game now. His return starts at the five. And he's brought down. The offense will come onto the field. Arizona has the football first to start the third, and here comes its offense. And they really lean on that passing game in the first half, Brock. Let's see if that emphasis continues to start the third. They'll get this drive started. First and 10. Running left, it's Connor. He breaks the tackle. And it's a nice gain off a really good effort there just to stay upright. Halfway there on first down. That brings up second and five.
This dude was just not going to be stopped, not by the first defender, heck, not even by the second one who was able to bring him down. No, it took a few shots before this crew could finally get this beast down.
Here's second and five. He finds the open man there, complete. It's a huge pickup on the play, and it'll be first down, Arizona.
You know, Kate, we often talk about flipping the field in special teams, right? A kick return, a good punt. Well, an explosive play like that does the exact same thing. Look at the difference in field position. By hitting on that shot, you've totally flipped the field and the tone of this drive.
Now they'll hit the line just outside the red zone following that big play. Now Murray. The throw is caught. And he's able to get it to the two before the stop. And even 20 yards on the play, and it awards them with a first and goal.
I may love watching a great thrower, but I love watching a well-done route too, Kate. Make that guy think you're trying to stack him only to drop your hips and cut right inside. Some good work to help reset those chains.
This offense in position now. It's first and goal. From the red zone now. Gets it towards the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I'm just going to say, maybe not the guy you want to pick on in coverage of this particular series. Gets a hand on that throw and knocks it away. The next time, well, he could get two hands on it and take it the other way.
So after the incomplete pass, here's second and goal. They'll send him up the middle. And he will carry this across for the Arizona touchdown. The Cardinals grow the lead coming out of halftime. It's a James Conner touchdown.
They're in a close game. They needed somebody to make that type of play. Now it pushes their lead to a couple of scores and makes a comeback that much more difficult.
You know, Kate, their offense did its part and padded the lead. Now it's up to this defense to make this two-score lead hold up and carry it across the finish line.
Prater on for the PAT. That one splits the uprights. And they'll continue adding to their lead. Now Prater on to send it away. This one's fielded at the 4-yard line. And a decent return ends as they bring him down inside the 30. The Panther offense headed out to the field. And they're going to try to take the lead back to one possession here after that last score pushed it up to 24-14. Set, first and 10. Young throwing here. Short pass caught by his tight end. And they get there to take him down right around the 41. Give him 30 yards on that one. And that'll be good for a Carolina first.
I think every quarterback around the world would agree, Kate. You love throwing a short pass to a tight end and then give that guy a chance to show off his speed in the open field. He outruns defense to make it a much bigger game.
So the big play gets him inside the opposing 45, Brock, with a new set of downs to boot. Throwing from the gun. Thielen's got it, complete. And they get this down to the 28. Big gain, 14 on the play. And it'll give the Panthers a first down.
I know the Combine tries to test everything it possibly can physically, but I don't know how you test courage at the Combine, because there's nobody defending you. Nobody wants to hit you. But that was the epitome of courage to make that in cut and make the catch.
Thielen, the receiver, in motion left. Now Young. It's caught. That's Thielen. And he gets this forward to the 19.
Well, there's a time to be a little finessey with the football, put a little touch on it. And then there's time to put your arm into it and let it eat, throw it right through your target's chest. This one, that one right there was the latter. Smart to make a fastball zing in before anyone could undercut the curl route.
From the 19.
score. Touchdown, Carolina. The Panthers start the second half with some needed points. Deontay Johnson with the touchdown. Well, they definitely wanted to get that one out quick, Brock. They did just that, and it ends in six.
We hear it all the time, but it is so true, Kate. This is a game about matchups. And when you see a throw that quick, it really was determined pre-snap. It was great design and tremendous execution.
Extra point try now from Pinheiro. That one right down the middle. And they're a point closer now on the scoreboard. Ollie set up and it's away. Just a three-point game now. Return coming from the six. And he's brought down. The offense will come onto the field. Ready to begin this drive, first and 10. Going with Connor here. And all he can get is 1 yard, ran that right into the defensive front.
One thing I could say positive about the execution of that play is at least he didn't go backwards.
They'll come to the line here, second and 9. Here's Kyler to throw. Got him in over the middle, complete. And he's going to be brought down at the 42. Give him 13 on that play. And that's a Cardinals first down.
Nice to see that connection, that chemistry working between the two of them.
They'll head up first and 10 from the 42. Running this with Connor. And they'll only find 1 yard up the gut. Second down.
New set of downs is not off to a real good start here, Cates. And I know every yard counts in this league, but that lone yard, it's not going to really change what they're thinking about doing here on second down.
They'll come to the line here, second and 9. Shotgun snap, looking to throw. Escapes the pocket. He's keeping it. Jukes one defender. They rip off a huge chunk of field as the downs reset.
That is so demoralizing for a defense. You lock things down in coverage. You do everything right on the back end. You need to see the quarterback escape, evade the pressure, and get that first down anyway.
What a spot for a big play, huh, Brock? It has him well into the red zone now with first and 10. Working inside the red zone. Jones reels it in. And he'll go down. Looks like they're marking him at the 11.
Well, he saw his guys pick up the blitz. Well, he felt them pick it up anyway if he wasn't looking at him. But with their effort on his behalf, I think this QB felt owed to them and the group up front to find somebody to get a completion so that effort up front wasn't in vain.
They'll run now on second down. And he will score. Touchdown, Arizona. The Cardinals make it a 9-point advantage. It's a James Conner touchdown. It's what every player who scores a touchdown wants to do, Brock. He wants to get right back there and put another 6 on the board.
I've never met an NFL player content with one end zone trip in a game.
Nope.
Yeah, if you're content, you're not making it to this league. You get one, you're instantly thinking of another, and the fortunate few are able to actually deliver on it.
Prater on for the PAT. That one splits the uprights. And they'll continue adding to their lead. Prater on to send it away. This one's fielded at the 4-yard line. And a decent return ends as they bring him down inside the 30. The Panthers and Bryce Young making their way back out on offense. They really had the passing game clicking on that last touchdown drive, partner. We'll see if they stick with that or if they mix things up a bit on this series. Drive starts out with a 1st and 10. Here's Young to throw. He finds Johnson. And he's going to bring it up to the 40-yard line before he stops. It's a gain of 12 there. And that'll be good for a Carolina first.
That is what elite offenses are all about. Why worry about three downs when you need only one? Move the chains in one play and keep driving that defense backwards.
Running with Hubbard out of the gun. And he's brought down by a collective effort there. Only 1 yard on the carry.
You know, not a ton of yards, but still showing that commitment to the ground game. The type of run that keeps the defense from loading up in coverage and focusing entirely on that passing game.
They'll come to the line here, 2nd and 9. Hubbard again. And once again, he doesn't manage much before getting brought down. They push it forward for 1 yard. That brings up 3rd and 8.
They got some positive yards. That's a good thing. But too many plays like that, it just is too hard to pile together, get first downs. It gets the better defenses in this league.
3rd and long for him here. It's tipped away and it's going to hit the ground. Incomplete. Defender winning that rep. That brings up 4th down.
I think it's safe to say that without that ball being tipped, we are looking at a big game. It's a missed opportunity to push that offense, but an even better play defensively to deny the throw.
Panthers getting everyone set for the punt. Absolutely crushed his first punt, and here's another huge one. And that hit right at the 10. Somehow, though, got a wicked bounce and makes it into the end zone for a touchback. Drive will start out with a 1st and 10. Here's the give to Connor. And he's able to get it to the 21 as he goes down. Just a gain of 1, and that brings up 2nd and 9. Kyler looking to throw. Rifles it, and it's caught. And he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Here they come. This is 3rd and 5. Now Kyler. Complete beyond the marker. And he'll get it out to the 34 before he's tracked down. That's a pickup of 9. And it'll be 1st down, Arizona.
You know, they call that the money down for a reason, because you're just simply not going to last long in the NFL if you don't convert a good portion of your third downs. It's the money down. And nice to see them roll the dice and continue the series.
Here's first and 10 from the 34. Out of the gun, they'll give it to him inside. And he's brought down after a short gain. He gets a couple on first, and they'll come up second and 8. That's the end of the third on Sunday night. The Cardinals have it with the lead. Just got to hang on for a little bit longer. Eight yards to go. Well, let's see how they approach this second down. From the 36. To the ground it goes. That's incomplete. Looking for his wide receiver there. And that's going to leave him with a tough third and long.
That play right there, Kate, that just goes to show you, you can't take any completion for granted. Even some of the shortest passes in the game plan.
Here he is on third and long. That one falls incomplete. Couldn't make the connection deep downfield. Marvin Harrison Jr., the intended target. So that brings up fourth and long.
Can't cover it much better than that really well covered, Kate, on that play. There just simply was not a window for him to sneak that throw in.
So on fourth down now, Blake Gillikin gets the call to punt it away for the Cardinals. He'll field this one at the 24. And they bring him down to put a stop to that return. It's a 54-yard punt that time. And that is where they'll start the next drive. First and 10 now from the 30. They're going play action. Complete. He loses the football. And the fumble recovery is made. Well, that didn't take long, Brock. One play, and they're back out there.
Well, that's how a defense can make you awfully happy as an offensive player, especially when you screw it up and you fumble. The defense picks up that offense and puts them right back on the field.
The Arizona offense about set to get going here. They didn't add to their lead last time out. They punted it away, but still ahead and able to add to it here. So just like all touchdowns, all turnovers also reviewed, and they want to take another look at this one. All right, so we all know what we're looking for here, Brock. Where did an elbow, maybe a knee, something touch down? And as it does, is the ball loose at that point?
Yeah, throw in forearm, wrist, shin. There's no question the offensive guy's screaming, something hit the ground, while the defense is hoping it didn't.
Take that fumble away. The officials overturn the call and say he was down. Nice spot here for the offense. It's second and one. From the 38. He's on the move. And they get to him as he was trying to make something happen. And that pushes him back. Third down coming up.
This is a time where you get in that huddle and you just look at one another and say, hey, let's get back in rhythm. Get back in rhythm. Get something good to feel good about. Sure, you'd love to get the first down, but more than anything, just find a positive play after a huge sack.
And there's an extra DB out there on the field now for the Cardinals. Third down coming. Motion man sent left. To the air. Third long. Buys time, rolling right. He's running for it. It goes as a gain of 19 yards. And it'll give the Panthers a first down.
As long as these are the results he's getting, they're going to be just fine with him calling his own number. He does such a good job of seeing the field and knowing when it's his time to take it himself.
First and 10, ball set up at the 48. Here's a give up the middle. And he's caught behind the line for a loss.
Well, he was supposed to be the one who chipped away a few and got a new set of downs started right in rhythm. Instead, he's now forced to pick himself from behind the line thanks to a great effort defensively.
Everyone's prepped. It's second down now. Shotgun snap, looking to throw. Escapes the pocket. And he evades any kind of trouble, but only a short gain to show for it after sliding down.
I love that play. I mean, that's quarterback 101. Nothing downfield. Get what you can with your legs, but so much more importantly, protect yourself. Availability, one of the most important abilities for any quarterback.
Throw on third down. Connection made to Tremble. And he's marked down, looks like at the 32-yard line. 16 yards on the play. And that'll be good for a Carolina first.
I'm not sure how this defense let that guy slip through him like that. On third down, nonetheless, he took that snap as an opportunity. And man, did he make an impact play.
It's a new set of downs for him at the 32. Looking to throw, Young. That's Thomas, he's got it. And he'll be brought down here at the 23-yard line.
Sometimes when you're just looking to move it forward, get some small yards on the throw, quarterback's best friend, security blanket. And when it's a big old tight end, that's an extra bonus.
Nice spot here for the offense. It's second and one. Here's Hubbard on the give. And he'll get them enough for a first down.
I don't know about you, Kate, but he sure made getting that first down look really easy. A lot easier than it's supposed to be for that defense. And I think they'll hear about it when they get to the sidelines.
They'll come up first and 10. From the red zone now. Throw complete to Thielen. And this one doesn't go far. Working quickly here. From the 17. Caught near the goal line. And he'll be taken down at the last possible moment. He's at the one. Give him about 16 yards on that gain, Brock, and it sets him up with first and goal.
They like to say it's about the Jimmies and the Joes. I think that's about the X's and the O's. That's a well-drawn-up completion that nets them a first down.
Touchdown, Carolina! The Panthers face a four-point deficit. Well, Brock, you know this better than most. Sometimes these dudes can be a quarterback's best friend, finding the tight end in the end zone for six.
And it really has been that way for decades when you think about it, Kate. From John Mackey to Tony Gonzalez to Travis Kelce. The position can be such a mismatch when you're throwing for the end zone.
And now for the point after, and crucially to bring things within a field goal. That one right down the middle. And they're a point closer now on the scoreboard. He's set up and it's away. Just a three-point game now. Kickoff taken at the three. And he's brought down just inside the 25 on the return. The Cardinals offense making its way out. And this really looks like a whole different ball game after that touchdown, doesn't it? They really need to go on a drive here. They'll get this drive started. First and 10. Kyler throwing here. Tight end reels in the shallow throw. And he'll push this upfield and earn them a new set of downs.
You want to become a quarterback's best friend, do that. Turn a short little gain, a short little pass, into some yards after catch, and that quarterback will find you again.
New set of downs for him at the 38. They'll run here on first down. And they love to see him fighting forward, but he only gets him 3.
Got to be rush hour, Kate, because there's a whole lot of traffic up the middle right there. He ran right into some gridlock, and he could only manage a few yards at most.
It's the 2-minute warning from Glendale. Cardinals holding on to a field goal lead. Second down now, 7 to go. It's Connor again. And he's short of the first after a mild gain. Now we get a timeout by the Panthers. It's their first. And they still have 2 available for them as we approach the end of this game. All plays on the table here for 3rd and 3. He'll throw it. He has the first over the middle. And he's down. Looks like they made the stop at the 46-yard line. Now Carolina's going to take a timeout. That's its 2nd. And they'll have just 1 left to burn now. New set of downs for him from the 46. First down, they'll run. And he's got a decent gain before being brought down. The defense takes its 3rd and final timeout as they'll meet and decide what to do on this 2nd down. Trying to get it with the option. And they've got him behind the line for a big loss.
It's easy for me to say up here in the friendly confines of the booth, Kate, but that was not the right read. And you hate seeing him absorb yet another hit at the end of the play. You never want him taking unnecessary shots throughout this game.
The Cardinals out for the punt. And this will be his 2nd effort of the contest. So this one carries all the way to the sideline and out. No chance to make a play on that, and they'll take over at the 16-yard line. The Panthers are being led back out there on offense by their quarterback. And this is some quality film review right here. Look at this, couple of touchdowns, good amount of yards too. He's been moving them down the field like only he can, putting together quite the game for himself in the process. They're out and set, 1st and 10. Looking to throw it. He'll dump this one off to his running back, complete. And they take him down at the 24-yard line.
Yeah.
So the Cardinals fight to a win here at home. And there was no easing up. It took some white knuckling until the very end, but their defense carried that small lead through to the finish line as they escape with the victory. So for my partner, Brock Heward, and our entire crew, I'm Kate Scott saying this has been the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Cardinals as we say so long from Glendale.